Welcome to AceMTG, and thank you to everybody out there who helped me celebrate my birthday on Saturday with my live stream. I appreciated everybody's support that you all gave me. Absolutely love doing those little things, and I like to do more live in the future. So let's go ahead and jump into this deck. So I don't think these Pia token decks are any surprise to anybody. We've seen them quite a bit, but I want to have a little bit of a story about it. So my very last deck I had in our last format, before Wilds of Eldraine came out, I was doing a Pia and Rocket deck because I was saying this deck is going to get so much better once Wilds of Eldraine comes out with all the adventure spells. I didn't realize, though, everybody's version was going to get rid of Rocco. So I thought that was a bad decision. I know a 5-0 league. I know every content creator in the world basically has made a deck like it, and they leave it out. And I just thought it was wrong. I was like, can't be the case. So I experimented a little bit with Rocco, and I also thought maybe because we're making so many little 1-1 Thopters, maybe giving a little bump to all of them as well, put a couple of the shield hairs in as well. Well, I ended up going 1-4 with that version. So I was like, all right, let's get rid of the hair and only put in Rocco. And I decided to put in 3 copies. I got rid of Chandra. I know it sounds a little crazy. I got rid of the Thrillseeker, and I got rid of the Warcrafting, and I got rid of the research desk to throw in one more Swiftspear. So 1-4 with my original version. Next version only changed 4 cards, putting in 3 Roccos, putting in 3 Swiftspears. And I ended up going 2-5 with that version. So I've yet to play the actual version, and this is the deck. So that's what I want to make a video on. Not much of a video on my other poor performances, right? I had an absolutely terrible record. My ranking started to drop quite a bit as well. So this is the version we're now going to go with. The same version basically everybody went with, the exact same version that people 5-0'd the league. And I'm incredibly skeptical of this deck. I'm just not sure how this is going to actually play out. So what I was constantly running into is I would get Pia out on turn 2 and was immediately killed almost every single time. And then sure, maybe I get a wedding announcement. Now maybe I'm sitting here with my Impulse, or I have to use my Questing Druid to start searching for cards. And I just was getting basically an empty battlefield. I wasn't able to really get all those Thopters online and swing in for the victory, kind of that dream scenario. I was constantly having my board wiped or my important creature killed. So I just was running into no luck. I don't know how much these small little changes are gonna really change that. But because everybody else did it, we always have to try it. I just am wondering, what is with all these one-ofs? And I know I heard other content creators say the same thing. It's like, I don't get it. One research desk. Well, we already have 12 sources where we're gonna draw cards and exile them and use that for Pia. What's with the one Warcrafting, the one Thrill Seeker? Okay, are those things necessary? In my opinion, I thought maybe, you know, you bump up your Invasion, you maybe bump up an extra Wandering Emperor, things like that. But this is the deck exactly how it was, so we want to test it out. Is this the version you should be going with, and how much play does this actually have? Okay, now again, any day, anything could happen on the ladder. You never know. Maybe my version with the Rocco in the long run would have ended up doing better, but I was just getting absolutely decimated, so we had to revert to this version. Make sure you stay to the very end of this video, and that's where I'm gonna give you my final thoughts of it and let you know what Jitsu belt this deck deserves. So let's go ahead and jump on the ladder and see if this Pia Tokens deck is just far superior than the one I had crafted. All right, got it. Rank 244. Time for us to rank up a little bit. Had a little bit of off time and my ranking has dwindled. Whew. Unfortunately, I can't even get this on turn 2 if I want to play that. All right, we'll keep. We're going to go tap land. Tap land probably just into the forge. Yeah. So tap land into the forge, into the farmland, and eventually we'll get this down. All right. We'll flash in our blocker. Go and pass. Great sleeves. Sleeves I do not own that I wish I did. All right, pass. They don't usually have any instants that could actually take care of this. They normally just have their Brutal Cathar that's up and ready. All right, so go and block there. See if we just have a straight up mono white. Oh, wow. Pass. That is surprising. Don't want to waste the value of this. So we're going to go tap land, and on their turn, we'll go ahead and use this. All right. Tap land. Go ahead and pass. I mean, what kind of mono white deck doesn't have a bunch of drops? This is very strange to me. Right, the fact that they ran that out, okay, that works. Get another red down. Impulse would have to be played now. Oops, I should have waited on that, okay. Wandering Emperor is obviously very likely, and there's a stick. They could have a Virtue of Loyalty themselves. Let's just get a little bit more value. Okay, ooh, double Pia. Kind of a waste one. So I'd expect a Wandering Emperor. Okay, takes care of one of my Swift Spears. And they're gonna stay right at 23 life. So next turn, it's definitely gonna be Pia. Okay. All right, so this is a mono white mid-range, more like control-ish style. So they just are probably using this just because of all the mono red aggro out there right now. Oh wow, that's gonna be big late game. Okay. Especially when they start bringing their sweepers on us. I think, well, we know we want this. I think I'd rather use my card draw now, try and find that land. We're gonna lose that Pia anyway. Okay, so we do like that. Go ahead and get that down. We'll swing all in at the Emperor, just let them have their little bodyguard, nice. Love to see every new card. Love the flash ability. Okay, so actually that is a good home for this one. I think Brutal Cathar is the better card, but I think the bodyguard, that's sweet. Boy, this is getting to be some trouble. But I think this bodyguard is really sweet to actually have in a deck like this. All right, no blocks. Destroy evil. Right. Whenever enters the battlefield or attacks, you may remove a counter from it. Shield counter. If this would be dealt damage or destroyed. So it has to be dealt damaged first. Let's go ahead and get this down. Get the invasion down. Shoot. Throw their squad. I could deal with those with my Chandra though. This is actually my biggest problem. So we'll take care of that. Go and get a land. Go all at the invasion, they block, and then we're gonna be able to actually take care of the warden. Okay. And now we destroy you. Ooh, they take off. I mean, that was gonna be a fun game there though. I mean, we're starting to take over. So let's just take a look at that battlefield. So once that's gone, on their turn, only thing taps Wandering Emperor is not great. You can still plus something. We'll get Chandra down, kind of take their board out a little bit. Yeah, I think we were getting close to starting to just take over with this game. Still, would have been fun to play out that hold one and a very nice first win. The Golden Crow. This month, man, he's been my opponent quite a few times. I go first. All right, so tap land into Pia. If it could stick, we got a little something working. All right. Let's see what they're playing. With another Pia, we like that. So here's the question. Are we the five color ramp? Yeah, we are five color ramp. Okay, so right off the bat, Reckless Impulse. Good, we get a land. Another Pia. Getting dangerous. So we have the red for Warcrafting. Don't think we're gonna need it. Destroy Evil is gonna be a little bit more vital in this game. So we're probably gonna play Pia anyway though, just to get that extra Thopter. Ooh. Or are we? Let's Impulse again. Okay, Leyland Binding. If we draw untapped land though, we get our next Pia right out. We miss completely. Oh, that hurts. Okay. So if we would have played Pia, we would have got an extra Thopter. And then they would have got rid of it anyway. Okay. I guess. And do we just search for the land? I think we just search for the land. Comes in tap though. So we're gonna lose our Virtue of Loyalty. Go and swing in for one. Ooh. All right, that's a little different. Not a terrible choice. Right, maybe you just don't like the Stomper? You'd rather that? Okay. Oh no, it's the Invasion. Oh, that's right, okay. All right, so we got this little combo thing going. So they're just about to pop off on us, and I saw it too, right? They just did two. So now they're gonna flip it, and we're just gonna sit back and watch this madness ensue. Another Invasion. Oh boy. Man, this deck is just so good when you, and they get the flip again. That's three in the graveyard though, I do believe. Oh no, okay. Yeah. All right, exile seven, flip again. I mean, we're gonna let them do the thing. We've obviously lost this game. There's just absolutely nothing we could do about it. Kills our land too. Maybe we should have invasioned earlier, right? We had to have got rid of that card. Probably a big mistake. So we're gonna let them do their whole process on our turn. We're just gonna pass, let them swing and get that victory. We're gonna be here a while though. So we have to go back and at least analyze our play, and I think the invasion was the only way we could have won. We would have stalled this at least two more turns. I don't know if we would have been able to build up a big enough battlefield, but absolute beatdown, and that is such a fun deck. So I was curious how long this deck would be able to stay viable and hang around, and without a lot of control in the format or a lot of mono blue tempo, I think it's gonna just continue to be a player. All right, I'm feeling mono red now, and after that beatdown, I could use something different. All right, we're going first. Ugh. You know, I'm just gonna even wait on the Swiftspear here. We're just gonna go tap land. Okay. Ooh. If they are mono red, nothing turn one. A little surprising. All right, we wanna go long game value, so I think I'm gonna draw off of this first. Let's go ahead and pass. Oh no, Izzet. Okay, this is fun. Get the snake so we get this down now so we don't start taking those pings. All right. Get this down. Deals X damage where X is 1+. Okay. So we can pay 0, right? Wait, Light of the Night deals X damage to any target. If it deals X plus 1 damage instead, if that target is a creature or a planeswalker. Okay. We'll go ahead and hit there. We'll take our one ping, kill it, and then we could still Reckless Impulse. So pretty good value. All right, now we got our Pia. Need to draw another land though, but Torchlight Tower's nice. Okay.
Listen, pal, I'm with the Gatewatch, so you might as well give up already.
That's got four power. So we're going Pia. And then don't want this to go to waste. Auto pay. So we'll hit it for two, and then we could swing in for another one.
Party's over for you, pal.
Okay. Kill my Thopter? Hit me in the face? I guess you go after Pia because you have another burn spell? Ooh, okay, you have a dragon in hand. I was not expecting you. This is a good to know situation. Plus us up. We still have the tower. I think Questing Druid start getting him big. Okay.
Watch me heat up the dance floor.
All right, good. Uses that. That's nice. Try and save it. I think we're going to have to go this route. And just two damage right there. All right, at least starting the growing process. Would love a land to get down our Swiftspear and then our wedding announcement. And then we can start using our Wrenn's Resolve. We will save our Destroy Evil for their dragon. That dragon could ever come out. All right, so Swift Spear. Wedding announcement. And swing in. All right, so now we can start building up a battlefield. We do have to be fearful of burn down the house. Okay. Still missing their land drops, though. So we're in pretty good shape. Just get all the damage in we can. We're not going to sack it. It would be an extra three, but next turn is going to be an extra three anyway. Okay, yeah, they're just not getting their lands. That's rough. All right. Go ahead and search. So I do love the value of this deck. Like, once you actually get going, get Swift Spear down. Don't think Destroy Evil is going to be for anything. Unfortunately, battles are not enchantments. We can just get rid of that. Little pause. I suppose you're sitting on a counter. Okay. More important, the extra two damage or the extra creature. I'm going to say the extra two damage. We're fine with drawing a card as well. Everybody grows. Get a land for next turn. We have eight. We have lethal right now, okay? If we hit him for eight, then we pop this. That's the 10. Anything they play, we'll be able to kill. So, yeah. All right, back in the win column. 2-1. Let's keep this thing rolling. All right, going first. We love that. We'll be able to get Pia down. Hopefully, we get that third land, get our wedding announcements going. All right, we'll go ahead and keep. At least we got a little bit of removal as well. So decent hand. We got our little speedo doggo. Uh-oh. Uh-oh, folks. Are we about to get comboed again? All right, where's my invasion at? I'm gonna use it this time. Yeah, I still assume it is. Yep, they run that as well. All right, so we go tap land. We'll use this on their end step, or will we? Actually, I think we need to start putting pressure on them now. They're just gonna, no, no. I'm looking for the invasion. That is what I'm looking for. This is gonna attack for 2 damage. That's still not fast enough. Because if on turn 5, they end up having their own invasion, we're just done. We kind of just have to find ours. Okay. Auto pay. Not it. We're doing it again. Oh, can't find the lands now. All right, well, we're out of options. All right, we go Pia. Just go the Druid. Actually, maybe that was a mistake. We probably should have searched for those top 2 cards. We need that invasion so bad, we had to look. Because this is just game over once again on turn 5. Dropped invasion. Here comes the raccoon. And raccoon. Holy cow, the raccoon actually missed for once. I mean, right, a tally's a miss. Ooh, Virtue of Persistence it gets. And a Wandering Emperor. And then next turn they'll get a Trax as well. So, I mean, they're gonna get it anyway. They didn't hit the big hit. And their hit is big enough. All right. I want to use this. I want to see if we would have hit the invasion. See if we screwed up. Okay. We wouldn't have hit the invasion. It wouldn't have even mattered. Go and get rid of you. You get it back every single turn, though. Wandering Emperor will take care of you. Swing at you. The nice thing is, if they get Atroxa, I could still kill that. We still are gonna have a little bit of value. Oh, wow. They go tally. Okay. What did they just steal off of me? Ugh. I mean, we're fighting the good fight, but I don't think there's much we could do. So we kill a tally. They get it back once again. Oh, they might just like wipe our board right here too. -4, kill 2 of our things. If I was them, I would kill my 2 Thopters. Because the Thopter could at least kill their Luca, but... Oh, wait a minute. It did kill all of it? I guess I didn't pay attention there. Okay. We'll get you down. Kill one of you. Bring back a tally again. All right, so far, our Pia token deck is doing really good until we go up against the 5-color invasion.
I will burn Phyrexia to ash.
And I didn't know how prevalent this deck was going to become on the ladder, though. After I played it, I only saw it, like, just very sparingly. Maybe it's just the day. All right. Doing their thing now. All right, we sit back. I think I need the little like Jeopardy soundtrack for my soundboard just as we sit here and wait. All right, good. That's lethal. GG's. I guess. So, I mean, that's just two absolute blowouts against that deck, and we're just not in it, even at all. I'm your boy, Blue. I like that name. That's a good one. All right, so we are going first. We will go ahead and try this out. Lean on the virtual loyalty in this one. We'll keep playing these until we have enough land, and then we'll use our... I think that's what we're going to do, right? We don't have green anyway. Okay, mono red. Just to play with fire. So we'll be able to sneak one of these in, and we'll block whatever they have. All right, this is good. Let's go and pass. Resolve. Let's put it down now. Let them know it's coming. We want to save as much damage as possible. Okay, so they'll have a land for next turn. We really will want to hit that fourth land. That fourth land is going to be so crucial. So we could double spell. I guess if they... That's tough, because if they already have the land and they don't need it, you don't really want to use that though either. Okay. Put this down. I think I'm just going to use the instant now. Just let's do that one extra little ping to them. Because if you have Squee or anything like that, you're putting it down anyway. If you have Godric, I couldn't block anyway. Okay. Now they do get the advantage. Okay. I was going to say you're going to get to kill it and, but... Monstrous Rage. That is going to be devastating next turn. Okay, so what we do. We get the land. This is interesting. I want to kill that Swiftspear. Real bad. I'm going to put it here, though. Yeah, we're just going to go like that. We'll end our turn. So if you try and put that rage on, I'm just going to sack it and kill it beforehand. Okay. This. And do we try it yet? We're gonna try it right now. Could have been a huge mistake us waiting. So they have another instant, and then also a Monstrous Rage saves it. And then we're going to take a whole lot of damage. Where if we would have just done that on our turn because we knew we wanted to kill it. We were getting a little greedy there because we were hoping, well, what if they have a haste creature and then they Monstrous Rage that anyway? We wanted them to make sure we wasted that, but they could outsmart us here. It does work. So maybe two and the Facid. Oh, okay. Just a Felden. Felden, Monstrous Rage was on that. Okay, so that was the thing we were worried about anyway. And that'll get a plus one. All right, so no blocks. They're gonna definitely Monstrous Rage. What, why? I'm very confused. Yeah, oops. Thank you for the three life. Unless you have another End of Festivities and you would rather just wipe out my board. Yeah, okay. Oh, we will take that all day long. All right. If we find a land, this is big. We do, but it comes in tapped. I think we'll keep taking that damage. Do I want to just get him down? Tough call, tough call. Yeah, we'll just get another one down. Let's get a little extra damage on our side. So hit him for 5, get them to 10. Lots of virtual loyalties to come down, but we're gonna wanna probably use our little burn spell. Maybe. A squee. Okay, well, we're gonna have to block. Another monstrous rage. Okay, just to play with fire. Okay, we can live with that. So we're also at 10. Let's go here. Here. Again, we're just searching for... Okay, so all that's going to be a waste. Get in. Go and end the turn. We're just going to use this just to kill the squee. It still exiles it, right? 2 damage target creature spell was bargained. Permanent dealt damage by torch to the exile it. Ooh. Okay. Wait for the second one. Wow, why do they keep doing that? Oh, shoot, 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 shoot. No, 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 no. All right, exile you. We grow. Whew, takes down mono red there. That's good victory. I mean, they're a little flooded though, right? You don't like to see them having 6 lands. Us having 3 of our virtual loyalties was really nice. I think we played that pretty well as far as timing. They did miss an extra 3 points of damage to us. We could have been at 6, would have made us a little bit more worrisome there, so. All right, so far we've been win one, play the 5-color invasion. Win one, play 5-color invasion. So can we avoid that this time? Do not love this hand, right? Because we have all the card draw, but we would need red. We're going to mulligan that a little better. I actually think we're going to ditch a pain land. All right, so we'll go ahead and keep. We'll ditch a pain land. Drop tapped. We'll go Pia. Gruul. Okay. Love to avoid a lightning strike. That would be lovely. Come on, just play your aggressive game. But thinking about it. I mean, they're deciding if they're going to attack. I'm obviously not going to block. We're worried about Monstrous Rage. A basic play with fire, right, is going to pump this up big enough. I block, they don't die. The play with fire then finishes off my Pia. Okay, that's perfect. I'm going to wait a little bit on you. Not that he's going to attack in anyway, but I'm just so used to doing it this way. All right, so get invasion. We love the hand information. Yeah, that's... All right, that's royal treatment. That is good to know. So 100%, it's gotta be you. Now we just need to start exiling some cards. All right, let's go ahead and pass. So that's 3, that's gonna bring it, okay, so they're pretty close to being able to bring it out anyway. I suppose we just need to make a big Pia. I would think they will drop Ruby and a Swiftspear. You have the mana up for the royal treatment when you need it. Okay. You could swing in because these are going to become 2/3. Okay, they don't do that. All right, I'm going to make Pia large. Or hold on. could pop that. I think a large Pia, though, is the way to go. I want that to stay on the battlefield. All right, we go and pass. So now when they do bring this down, I have no problem blocking it. Because it's going to take all five mana to get him down. Nobody else will actually be considered a hasted creature. Even if they get six, it's still only a 3/4. All right, so we at least have a nice wall. Now we just need to find all our exile effects. Light up the night to any target. So we flip that. We swing in for four. We could sack it if we had to. Don't really want to sack that. Fun game. Okay. And then play this, so you get a flyer. I like that. Go ahead and pass. So legendary creatures you could save. Oh, doesn't do it. All right, my turn. I find that to be interesting. All right, we're still passing. Problem is, I would flip this, I would attack in, you would... I guess if they double block like that, I put all the damage here. Yeah, that's still a 1/1, and we don't like that. Our entire deck goes along this. I'm going to be forced to sack this, and they're only going to lose one creature for that. Now, if I flip it... So if I could flip it with the Thopters, obviously then we're off. So they know they could play a Smut. They're kind of waiting on it, though. All right, my turn. Yes, huge right there. Doing it right off the bat. Because three mana, basically we play everything on our deck, so we know we're going to drop something. So we get the land. Yes. And we get the wedding announcement. And now we're absolutely off to the races. This is X damage and charge, where X is 1 plus a creature or planeswalker. Okay. Those two attack there. Let's see what they have. What little tricks? Do we just pop it right now? Yeah. Wait. Let the damage go in first. All right, we're going to pop that. So now we'll start growing our Thopters. We'll get another Thopter next turn. And that's Exile. All right, end the turn. I feel like we've now taken over. We have 19 life. We have plenty. I don't know what they're waiting on Smut for. That's my confusion. I know you want the haste to get it in there. And they do that on my end step. Another thing I don't understand. I mean, 4/4 is big. You could start taking to the air if you could double drop with both those cards. I'm probably just going to use a Swiftspear, because Swiftspear is never getting in. Okay, that's one. Oh, hello. All right. They want to put the pressure on us. I will sack this if I have to. Pass. I want you dead. Seven, eight, nine. We'll do it just like that, because we could sack this if we have to. Three blockers. Because if they want this actually, so if they're smart, let all this damage come through, then you try and burn it off at the end. Because if you try and use your kill spell, okay. Just save everybody? Nah. We just let it go. Yep, resolve. That's fine. All right, I mean, this is a hit. We are at five. That is dangerous. My turn. Okay. We need to pay 3, 4 with this. So this is 5 mana. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And then I have 2. Okay. So we go ahead and get this down. We get a Thopter. We pay 3. Because that'll do 4 damage. Yes. Auto pay. Ward 1. All right, so we took care of that. One of our Thopters will block. We're only at 5. We can't afford that. Okay, we'll go like that. All right. Oh, we have something interesting. If they top deck something big, we could be in trouble. Oh, good. That's right. Another creature there. Forgot about that. That's why I didn't want to attack with 2 anyway. So if you want this to come down, you would have to tap it. Blocking all day here. And block. We're going to block everything, no matter what they do. It all comes down to that one card they drew. Right, what's the worst thing they could have drawn? Okay, that's totally fine. Worst thing they could have drawn would have been a lightning strike. One pass. All right, my turn. What a big draw. Oh my goodness, that was about the best top deck we could have got. They have no enchantment for us, right? Okay. We'll play another. Get another little 1/1. Get our land down. We're going to play this just to get another 1/1. Yes. Keep our big one. And we don't need another. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 3, 4. We have 5. Let's just keep 1 back. So 2 attacks. Now the whole squad grows, and I get to draw a card. Okay. And then we could swing in for the air for the victory next time, right? That's 15, 16, 17, exactly perfect. And you drop anything big, we get to kill it. And we have a blocker for everything. So I think this is just game over. What a good one. This was one of those tight, intriguing matchups where we really had to kind of line everything up, do the math between every single play to make sure we're okay, right? We're willing to get a hit big enough to get us to where we're at only because we know with Gruul, there's not a big enough burn spell. They would have needed a couple burn spells, which still could have been risky though. Which, did we even see a burn spell? Let's just take a quick peek. They could be running just no burn. All right, good game. Welcome back, and I have to say, this version was definitely better than mine. We ended up going 4-2, not too many games, but we kind of reached the time limit. That last game was a super exciting one with Gruul, went pretty long there. But overall, those four wins were more wins than I had with my couple versions, and I ended up with like 9 or more losses from those versions. So obviously there's something here. Now, as far as which Jitsu belt I think it deserves, I'm gonna say Purple Belt for now. I'm not willing to go higher. I know it is a talk of a town, 10-0'd or 5-0'd, different things, and different content creators have done really well with it, but in the long run, I'm not seeing the superpower. Yeah, we got some victories, and our only losses happened to be against that five-color invasion deck, which absolutely just steamrolled us. We had no hope in it. However, I didn't see really those control matchups. You notice in my video today, the problem I said I was having before was my P was getting killed right away. It somewhat happened, but this time I was able to actually rebound and keep going with it. Chandra, we didn't end up even really using it. We never actually saw the research desk. The Destroy Evil is definitely necessary in this deck. This was definitely a good one to have. Three copies, maybe, because we don't have that much other removal. So I do think there are a couple cards that maybe can be tinkered with. I still question about the Chandra. I would love to see it really pop off. Now, once it does come down, this is gonna be a late game answer. But is this really a late game deck? And maybe I'm looking at it totally wrong. Maybe I was thinking that this thing is fairly aggressive, but because it's tokens and we're kind of waiting, we're getting the virtual loyalty down to slowly grow it, maybe this is realistically more of a mid-range style deck. And the other thing we didn't necessarily get to see is we didn't get to see it go against the mono red aggro with that absolutely beautiful curve. We did go against mono red aggro and we were able to win that game. We won all the games that were not five color invasion. I just am not willing to give it more than a purple belt, which still, that's a high belt. Anybody who does jiu-jitsu, anybody knows a purple belt, they're gonna beat that average standard deck out there, right? They're gonna be able to get you up through those different levels, but in platinum and diamond, I think you will struggle, and I think you'll sit there and go kind of 50-50, 55%, things like that, and just slowly build with a deck like this. Again, I could be totally wrong. I was wrong in the first place. I knew Rocco and Pia would be good later on. I didn't just realize you were gonna get rid of Rocco and it's gonna be a straight Pia deck. So I definitely missed it on this one. And so I'm probably not the best one to listen to my advice on it. I just, for my gameplay, I can't fully see it, even though we did very well today. So once again, thank you to everybody who tuned in for my live stream, for my birthday stream on Saturday. I really appreciate it. I had a ton of fun. I loved all the support you all gave me. And until next time, never forget, you're an ace.